You know, there's a lot of rides out here to ride on the Thrillway, and for $24 tonight, you can get a wristband and ride to your heart's delight. But with the rides right there, you've got Kentucky Kingdom, the old abandoned Kentucky Kingdom, and there's a new push to get it up and running today. In fact, the State Fair Board is soliciting new proposals to make bids to be a new park operator. This comes just hours after an old source submitted a new proposal. WLKY's Lexi Sheen has been checking into all this today, and she joins us now just outside the Thrillway and right next to the old Kentucky Kingdom. Lexi, how's it going over there?
Well, Rick, exactly like you said, when you think of the State Fair, this is exactly what you think about. You think about the Thrillway, the rides, the bright lights, all the fun and games out here. But right next door, it's definitely a different sight. Behind me, you can see the old Kentucky Kingdom. For the third year in a row, the gates are closed, the park is vacant, and also unkept. But this week, businessman Ed Hart submitted a new proposal with his group, and the Fair Board this morning decided to ask for other options.
Where is the faith in Kentucky Kingdom? Aren't we the possibility city? Shouldn't we be doing things like the theme park?
2 months after a deal with the Cook family falls through, Ed Hart and company come back to the Fair Board with a new proposition worth $40 million.
Instead, the Fair Board is demonstrating a lack of urgency and going back to the beginning.
Ed Hart, Ed Glasscock, Mary Mosley, and Bruce Lunsford submitted their paperwork Wednesday afternoon, but at the State Fair Board meeting Thursday morning, the board chose to issue a request for proposal, or RFPs, to solicit an operator for the amusement park.
Let's have everybody step up that is interested in doing some kind of an amusement center out here.
The theme park world at large knows Kentucky Kingdom's been closed for 3 years. Are these proposals all of a sudden going to start falling out of the sky?
Hart says he could have it open in 2014. Of their $40 million plan, $10 million would be his group's investment. $30 million would be from a bank loan that they're asking the state to guarantee, which is where the disagreement lies.
Puts the taxpayers on the hook. And I don't know how interested the taxpayers would be in the state taking that kind of risk.
The $40 million of new equipment and rides is collateralizing the $30 million. If anything happened, you could sell off what you just bought to pay for the loan.
The board has put a 60-day time limit on the new submissions, but Hart says that's a major delay, adding that their proposal picked up where Holiday World left off.
We accept the exact same lease they were going to give to Holiday World. Just, there's nothing to negotiate. The Fair Board already approved that lease.
Now, the Fair Board did not even consider Hart's proposal today. Instead, they decided to ask Hart and his group to resubmit, their proposal in reference to these new RFP guidelines. So they are still considering whether or not they will do that. Hart says he definitely has to meet with his three other business leaders to decide if that's a possibility. Governor Beshear says he's hoping this process will dictate if it's even possible to open another amusement park here or if the state should pick a new use for this property. Live at the State Fair, I'm Lexi Sheen, WLKY News.